Many of you will be sat on the fence when it comes to the Galaxy Fold 3, and for good reason. Buying such an expensive phone, and arguably fragile phone, is certainly something that you want to give some thought. That being said, I've got the Galaxy Z Fold 3 right here, and I want to show you 5 apps that work so much better on a folding phone, and it might just help you make that decision. So sit back and relax whilst we explore the top 5 apps for the Galaxy Z Fold 3. Stay tuned. What is up, guys? Welcome back to Tech It Easy. More Fold 3 content for you today. Today we are of course taking a look at my top 5 picks for the best apps for the Galaxy Z Fold 3. If you do have any suggestions yourself, please do feel free to put them down in the comment section. Before we do move on, if you could quickly leave a cheeky like and subscribe to the channel if you find yourself enjoying the video, that would be awesome. Also, do check out the Discord server. We will be dropping some exclusive coupons for free Galaxy Watch 4 faces down there. So if you're interested in that, make sure you've signed up. Without further ado, let's jump into the video. Our first app of the day for the Galaxy Z Fold 3 is none other than Trello. Trello is a crucial tool for me to help me keep organized. You essentially have a board which you can add cards to and separate them into different lists. Usually, for example, I have video ideas on the left, then when I start working on them, I slide them over to my In Progress tab. I also tend to write notes or parts of scripts when I get an idea, so I add custom labels to the cards to indicate that I've started the scripting stage. It's a really useful tool, but I always felt that it was better optimized for a desktop experience. The Fold 3, however, has solved this issue, essentially giving me a desktop experience in my pocket. Definitely an app to try out if you need some help keeping organized and keeping on top of things. A very simple solution to keep you productive. App number 2 is one to take advantage of if you've bought the S Pen with your Galaxy Z Fold 3. This one is called Sketchbook. Worth mentioning that you do need to buy a special version of the S Pen, so double check it is compatible with your Galaxy Z Fold 3. For example, you cannot use the Note 10 or Note 20 stylus on your Fold 3. Anyway, Sketchbook is very similar to Photoshop, but purely geared towards painting and sketching, and also in your pocket. Now, I'm obviously no artist, but I would suspect that some of you could make some quite professional looking paintings using this app. The extra screen real estate on the Fold 3 really makes it the perfect digital pocket sketchbook. You have all your various brushes, pencils, pens, automatic pressure detection, you name it. It's definitely worth checking out if you're an artist. There will be a link down below to download the app. Now, do you want to know how to get Spotify Premium absolutely free? Well, before we move on to our next app, crypto.com are offering $25 signup bonus when you use the link below, and if you stake for their Ruby Red card, you can get a 100% rebate back on Spotify every single month, saving you around $100 or £100 a year. Crypto.com even offer a free Visa debit card which gives you 1% cashback on any purchases you make. Based off the average spend of a household, you'd be looking at saving up to $50 or £35 a month. And that's just for their free card. The cards go all the way up to 8% cashback for their top tier card. Definitely check out crypto.com using the link below. Now, app number 3 is actually a game, and I know there are thousands of other games that I could have picked here, Minecraft being one of them, but Bloons Tower Defense has just felt awesome on my Fold 3. You really appreciate the extra room on the display, all the colors really pop, and if you get to some of those higher levels, the performance capabilities of the Galaxy Z Fold 3 really start to shine through. If you haven't tried Bloons before, it's such a fun little game to pass the time. For many of you, it will bring back some good memories of your childhood. So let me know in the comments if you've played Bloons before, and if you have, what is your favorite tower? Now, app number 4 is actually Xbox Games Pass. It might seem a little bit of an obvious one, but if you haven't tried cloud gaming out yet, now is the time to do it, especially with the Galaxy Z Fold 3. The Fold 3 is literally perfect for gaming on the go. Simply connect a wireless controller to your phone via Bluetooth and you're good to go. Now, you could argue that Games Pass is still a bit jittery and some games are pretty much unplayable, and you wouldn't be wrong, but you can get games like Age of Empires now, which are perfect for on-the-go cloud gaming. Definitely try out Xbox Games Pass if you haven't already. There are tons of sign-up offers out there. You can get up to about 3 months free, so well worth trying. Last but not least, app number 5 is Anydesk. Now, there's hundreds of different remote desktop apps out there, but I personally found that Anydesk is definitely the best free one by far. I can connect to my PCs even using my 4G pretty much seamlessly. Connecting a wireless mouse and keyboard to the Fold 3 basically feels like I've got a laptop in my pocket. I wouldn't recommend trying to game through it, however, but if you are looking for an alternative to Games Pass, a bonus pick for you would be to try out Steam Link, which also lets you remote into your PC and play your favourite PC games via Steam. Anyway, there's not much more to say about Anydesk. It does what it says on the tin, but it's a really, really good remote desktop app, definitely worth getting on your Fold 3. As with all the other apps, the extra screen real estate really does make all the difference, and it allows you just to be that little bit more productive. So those are my top 5 picks for the best apps for the Galaxy Z Fold 3 in 2021. As always, let me know in the comment section which one was your favourite, and if you did find yourself enjoying the video, please do leave a like and subscribe to the channel. For now though, I've been Alex, thank you so much for watching, and remember, take it easy.